I was pleasantly surprised and well satisfied with the movie called Krishnarjuna Yudham. It's an Indian movie with mostly in Hindi, but they do speak some English in it. But it's all with English subtitles, so you can read it all. It was playing here in at the Monrovia movie theater. Now I've started to watch more of these Indian movies over the last year because of I use the MoviePass card, so I'll experiment with movies that, if I was paying out of pocket, I might not do so before. And there's various theaters around here, but also in Northern Cal, Milpitas, they have a lot of Indian movies there as well. So you can find them at mainstream theaters if you look around. And I was in there with three, I think three or four others. There were three or four others, and I think they were all of Indian heritage. So they are probably, they didn't need the subtitles, but they were enjoying it. And their sense of humor is something I appreciate. I had a few friends from India when I was in college, so I like them, and they're pretty decent people. And I know there's this mixture of Hinduism or Buddhism, maybe mostly Hinduism, I think, in India, which we don't agree with as Christians, but there are some noble aspects to Hinduism. They do have a sense of honor, integrity in general, as far as I can tell. My friends that in college, of course, well, they profess to be Christians because we were at a Christian college, so anybody who comes there to be admitted, you have to profess your faith as a Christian. Now, that doesn't mean some people don't just say it because they want to get into the school, but that's a whole other story. So anyways, and the movie is long. I think it was like 2.5 hours. So you're getting a real epic movie. And this is kind of what I call it, an epic love story. And that's another thing I like about it, is that in general, they're still well-rooted in traditional marriage and courting and that sort of thing. Man and woman. They don't have all this American liberal stuff that's injected into almost every Hollywood movie now. So you can rely on it being more like a 1950s movie in terms of relationships, meaning men like women, women like men, and that's it. And monogamy is the rule. Although, in this film, it starts out with this rock star named Arjun, and he's kind of a womanizer. In fact, they show some of the men in the film being womanizers, but as the film progresses, both of the main characters, both men, start to chase the girl of their dreams, as they think they have found the girl of their dreams who they want to be with their whole life. And Arjun, the rock star, who's been with many women, at least that's the fable, that's the myth or the reality, who knows, he decides he's ready to settle down with this woman, but this woman doesn't like him at all. She's not impressed with rock stars like so many other women. And so it's a long chase for him to try to get her to like him. And he'll do anything, he says. Meanwhile, there's parents and grandparents involved. And there's another character. The other main character, his name is Krishna, which is also, of course, the name of a Hindu god, right? Or Hare Krishna, whatever that means. I thought it was whatever it means. It's a Hindu or some kind of Indian name. And So he's chasing the girl of his dreams. And there's a lot of action in it as well. And then also they have these Indian movies are also kind of like musicals, because every now and then they'll stop and there'll be like a group sing along. And they'll all perform sort of choreographically, which makes it interesting and fun. Entertaining, relaxing, you know, all those things. And also, there's another aspect to this movie. It's about stopping the trafficking problem, meaning the worldwide problem of human trafficking, where the bad guys are taking mostly women, kidnapping, whatever the case may be, and turning them in some cases into sex slaves against their will, and also other cases where there's human trafficking in terms of employment, where people will go somewhere else in the world to work and then find out they're not being given the honest information, and they're turned almost into slaves. And so that's the way the story goes. And the movie continues to show these two men chasing the two women in separate scenes. They're not together. But eventually, towards the end of the film, they will run into each other because they have a common purpose. Because both of the women end up getting kidnapped by these human traffickers. And so they have to chase down the human traffickers to save their girls. And also save many other girls from trafficking. I have a human trafficking blog that I continue to update on a regular basis. So it's a cause that I also am concerned about. And so for Christians, I do these movie reviews for Christians. I've mentioned that these are good films, even for kids. I think they show good role models, even though they might not be Christians, but they show good role models in terms of heterosexual relationships and the courting process that we should value and cherish. And not say, oh, that's so old-fashioned. That's a good thing still. And this shouldn't be just thrown out because it's old. So, it's a movie we're seeing, and I encourage everybody to also pray for upholding traditional values everywhere in the world, and especially here in the United States. Traditional biblical values. God be with you all and bless you. Pray for you and encourage you to keep believing and keep the faith and keep growing in Christ and keep trying to fulfill the Great Commission. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.